Hello guys, today I'm going to talk about something very special happened yesterday, and probably I will review some Chinese real in my hands, real Chinese tube amps, etc., etc., and that will be the second part of this video. The first part is about, well, I told you in my last video that I will buy a Beamer. That I'm thinking of buying a Beamer, not 100% sure, but 90%. And there are two exceptional good and cheap Beamers, Chinese Beamers at the moment. And one of them is this one, the Watsco Vzatko C2 4K. It is also selling under different brand names, yes. This have a price from €210, but €210 means no Android, no Wi-Fi or Wi-Fi, and not a smart home theater. You know, you understand? So you have two or three different kind of options. The cheapest options is the one from €210. You understand? If you only want to spin your videos from your laptop, this thing is good enough. But anyway, let me explain you what this thing have, why this thing have my biggest, let me show you why my biggest interest go to this one. This thing have a digital keystone correction 4D. That means as well horizontal as vertical keystone correction, yes. And this guy is reliable because he have already 621 orders and 168 people who say, well, trustworthy, I got the thing on time, everything, if something is wrong with the thing, the contact with the seller is very good. You understand that what I could read. I will place the link from this Beamer in the subscription box. The other Beamer, you understand, this is full HD, yeah? Don't underestimate it. Full HD LED. So that means this lamp, if you don't have LED Beamers, often these lamps go 2,000 to 3,000 hours, and then you have to change for a new lamp. And those lamps are expensive, and they use a lot of energy, so power. LED is cheaper in power use, and the lamps go, well, for a lifetime, over 30,000 hours, yes? So 10 times more than a normal, old-fashioned Beamer. And the second one I had in my mind was this Toyinger T26K, also full HD, and also this one have you can buy in two versions from €170 to €233, euro. And also this guy have a lot of orders, and 278 people say, well, give their comments 4.8, as you can see. 88% give this guy 5 stars, only 2% give him 1 stars. So, and when you compare that with this guy, 1% give him 1 star, and 5 stars is 93%. So this guy is, both of them are pretty reliable. And, but this thing, I think, I'm not sure, I could not find that info. All of them have a normal, as you can see over here, I think the sound of the other one is better. Better speakers. 2 times 10 watt is the other one. This is 2 times 3 watt, but yeah, you connect the thing. You can connect the thing, both of them you can connect through the 3.5 millimeter jack audio out to your amplifier. So, and as you can see over here, it have an auto keystone correction, but this image, don't tell me if it is 4D or only horizontal or vertical keystone correction. Yes, so I'm not sure about that. And these are all the possibilities you have with this. With this very cheap, but full HD. And there are people out there, but yeah, why would you buy? Because you understand, I have the choice between a television from 65 inch, yes, and a 65 inch television costs today 650 euro, and that's cheap. That's cheap, it's very cheap, my friends. And then you have 4K. But yeah, a lot of programs are still not in 4K, and so. Well, as you can see over here, beautiful images. And but you understand, I'm not sure which one to buy, so I discovered this guy. I will place a description or a link from this YouTube site, this YouTube video, also in the description box. So this guy placed them on each other and do the VS test. The thing is that this guy is Russian, and I understand, I can speak Serbian, and a lot of Serbian words are almost the same as Russian, but I understand only 25 to 30% what this guy is telling. So, but what I understand is that he preferred the one below, so the more cheaper one. I like more the looks of this one, and this one is brighter, I thought. But this is how it is showing. So this guy is, let me open it completely. So this guy is doing a full test. And for example, as you can see with this Wikipedia, and as you can see, the letters in the one I first had in my mind is, as you can see over here, it have a different name. But TZ26K, that's this one. That's this one, the T26K. Yeah. And the other one, the Ratko C2, yes, that is the S in his video. It is the S1080, so a different name, but the same as the Ratko C2. And as you can see, the letters in his video.
Нету, но мне кажется, что на S1080 с текстом чуть-чуть хуже, чем на T26K. Сейчас вы можете видеть, в принципе, разницу между.
Yes, you can see here that the cheaper model is much more readable than the more expensive model I had in mind. And
Ничего не поймете, только при
example here, you can see that a lot of stuff here in this image is fake. And in this image, so the cheaper model, it's better viewed. And what I
сравнении.
also discovered from this video is the next thing.
Так, включаем. Тут, в принципе, я вижу слегка 20.
You can see it is more vague this one than over here. Yeah.
9-й, а тут я вижу тоже. С S1080. Тут более светло-черный, вот S26K он темнее. Синий, это тоже. Это у нас синий. 27-й, 28-й был. Зеленый у нас, я вижу здесь на 6-м. Тут тоже на 6-м есть. Там получше тоже будет 27-й, 26-й.
This is white. As you can see, the more expensive one have a more beautiful white, but not in the corners, as you can see. Also, this one is vaguer in the corners. And
Вот видим, как белый цвет выглядит. Тут он более белый по сравнению с
that's because the more expensive one have more lumen, more
T26K
light.
черный. Тут более светло-черный. Вот T26K он темнее. Синий. Этот синий мне нравится больше, чем этот. И
So
смотрю.
the one below is the more cheaper one. Yes.
Камера там что-то показывает. Зеленый цвет здесь тоже более глубокий по сравнению с S1080. И красный тут. Вот сразу видно, что насыщеннее цвета на T26K.
As you can see, the blacks in the cheaper one is more beautiful. Real black. Also, if you can read these letters, and here, hard to read. So.
Тут у нас никаких проблем нету, но фокус видно, что лучше на T26K. Текст читается.
Also here, the letters over here far better readable than the letters over here.
Лучше здесь у нас на T26K.
Well, this is just a picture, and as you can see, the colors of these ladies in the more expensive model, they look a little bit, well, flats. The colors are not nice, and in the more cheaper model, I prefer the more cheaper model in these colors.
Вот наши женщины. В принципе, все равно не особо похоже. Тут...
Also in this picture, it is clear which Beamer is better.
Лучше картинка, чем здесь. Там было лицо, видно, что в пересвет на S1080. Тут вот вообще конкретно идет в пересвет. В своих проекторах. Замки лучше.
If you see this example, then you can see this is real gold and this is fake. Watch this over here, this piece, and here. It's overlighted, like it is overlighted, and this has all to do with the lenses inside this beamer.
Выглядит здесь, но тут тоже очень похоже. Чуть-чуть светлее кажется. По цветам все нормально, зеленый лучше видно. Только цвета более насыщенные на T26. В принципе, как мне кажется, победил у нас T26K. Хоть у него картинка чуть-чуть слабее. Сразу же слышу, что по звуку, по вентилятору проигрывает T26K. Я его слышу больше, чем S1080. Так что, в принципе, плюс. У S1080 его не должно быть, потому что оба проектора показывают одинаково. Значит, это...
You can clearly see the difference between the videos, the two beamers, that the picture below is much smoother.
Какой-то глюк у меня там, может, проекторов.
And he also do a sound test over here, because also this beamer is a little bit more quieter than the other one. But I have the plan when I buy this thing to open it, when I buy one of these, to change those fans in silent fans, so almost noiseless, you understand? And well, this is automatic from the cheaper one, automatic from the more expensive one, and you can see the difference is that the image of the more cheaper one is far better. Anyway, so I think I almost made up my mind. You know, I'm glad I discovered this guy, and well. Let me see over here, where was it? Where was the video? Over here.
Всем привет! Сегодня будем сравнивать два проектора S1080 и T26K. Оба проектора у нас
I'm
имеют.
I'm almost out of my thinking, and you see everything is in Russian, and if you place it on translate to Dutch, it stay on Russian, because this is Cyrillic lettering. And there is no translation for Cyrillic lettering, so it is impossible to see what he is writing Or you have to do it piece by piece in translation, Google Translation, then you have the right translation, but I don't have the time for that. Maybe I have to do that, you understand, to be 100% sure what he is thinking. But I think that his what the show he just gave is enough for me to say, well, this is the better one, the T26K. And for the unbelievable price of, if you only want, you can connect your for 170 euro, you understand, you can just connect your laptop through it, or your TV box, you understand, so you can watch TV. And if you pay a little bit more, so 60 euro more, you have Android 9.0 Wi-Fi connection, and AC3 is optional. So I think you need AC3. I think you need it. So I think I will buy this. I will pay this 203 euro instead of that. I will buy them the one with all the functions, the complete thing. And I'm not sure where I'm going to order it, if it is this site, because there are a lot of Chinese sites who also sell this thing. But I'm not sure yet where I'm going to order the thing. But I think it will be in the end, not sure yet, you know. I take my decision in a month, and in a month a lot of can change. New beamers around, maybe better ones. But until now, I think this will be the one. My distance is 3 meters 60, so my room is 4 meter wide. But this thing also is, I think, well, 30 centimeters wide. And I'm not sure if I'm gonna place a screen, or I gonna beam it to my wall. My wall is wide, but my wall is not well, egal. It's not eagle, egal. So it is, well, not sure what I'm going to do. A new screen, a 120 screen, cost about 150 euro, a electric one. So that would be an a extra well, investment. So not sure if I'm going to do that, understand? And so this is with the other one. So the Watsco, this is what from this distance, 3 meters 6, you have a 120-inch screen. And I'm not sure, because my speakers are too high, I'm not sure if I have to beam between my speakers in, you understand? And the other one, the Watsco, I'm gonna show you. The Watsco, what I understand is from 3 meters 6, it gives only 106 inches, and that size I can handle, because my speakers are too high, you know. Or I have to place my speakers. I will place my speakers anyway out of each other, because I will change this table, so I have. The image will be between the speakers. And what I know from this beamer, that from a distance from 3 meters 60, yes, you can see over here. Well, I know I already find this out, that from 3 meters 60 you have 106 inches, and the other one from 3 meters 6 you have 120 inch. So that's the difference, you know. And well, not sure. I think the other one, I think I will buy this. And of course, both of these beamers, you have a zoom, so you can cut off 25%, so 120 inch will be around 95 inch. Yes. And but and both of these beamers have this possibility. And the only question I still have is this keystone correction. Is it only horizontal, vertical, or both, also in this one? Because that's not very clear to me, not yet. So it have a 50 degrees auto keystone and 50 degrees if you do it manual. You understand it? It looks like it can handle everything. You understand? Watch this. Watch this image. And but I'm not sure, so I have to find it out. Anyway, second part of my video, my friends. My last video that was the best second-hand speaker under $100. You have to see this video if you didn't saw it yet. A very interesting video, and you will learn something new. What is how you can have a good sounding speaker under $100, and this guy reacted, Johnny Reciprocity, and this guy is a Dutch guy living for a long time in Vancouver, Canada, and he is like me, a audio idiot, because he have his home room full with stereo equipment, you know, and this guy give me this tip: new CD player and wrote a single CD, current Onkyo, or a Winner or Tone Winner or Tone Winner TI-20. So this is the possible the same like the Onkyo. Both new around, oh, they are different. Both new around €300, blah blah blah. And he told me it is a very good, exceptional good CD player, and this thing is an HD CD player. And he gave me the link where he ordered two of these things. And then I opened this link he gave me, and I came on this site. And well, I can tell you, well, let me do it directly. Let me do it directly. And then you come on this site, and then you see what he was talking about. For only $300, you can buy for 11 kilo. And believe me, guys, I had a few exceptional good CD players, also SA CD players, but I never had a HD CD player. And this thing is a HD, as you can read over here, HD CD player, because the thing have a impossible 24-bit 384 kilohertz DAC, and that's remarkable for this price. For €300, my friends, you can, that's the price of a very good SA CD player in the Netherlands, second hand. You understand what I mean? 10, 15 years old. And this guy is selling them for this price, brand new, but even better than the SA CD. This guy is selling HD CD for that same price with 11 kilos. So only the weight tells you, can show you, or tells you, look the inside, that this is a very good building quality. Watch the remote control, also beautiful. So I go to this, I went to this guy homepage, but I remember I already saw this web page once. But yeah, which one is trustworthy? You know, a lot of people have websites, and when you order, you do, you lose your money. You get zero. You get zero, and you lost your money. You understand? And this guy is already for years, what I understand, because I went Googling this guy, this shop, for years online. Very trustworthy, you understand? And it's a very fair guy, what I understand. You know, if there are problems with the equipment, if you know, if there is a problem with the shipment, this guy is very, very fair. You understand? It's not an asshole like many companies who say, "Well, you already paid me, so you got a broken thing." Well, it's not my problem. You understand? And I saw, wow, these whole things I want, I have interested in, and so I mailed this guy, Mr. Lee, and I had a nice email conversation with him, and that was last night, after Johnny gave me this link. And I can tell you that me and Mr. Lee from this site are going to work together. Not sure how. We are still on discuss how I'm going to review some things from him, maybe from a distance. I think that will be some parts from a distance, but then you don't know the audio quality, what I think from the audio quality. And possible he will also send me once in a while a item for free, so I can review it live to tell you how it sounds to my ears. And well, that would be a very, very nice cooperation. And I'm looking forward to this. There will not be many videos, I told him. I am prepared, I'm willing, I'm glad to do this, but maximum 2 videos a month, because I don't want my website is Vintage Stereo and it will always stay Vintage Stereo. And this is the agreement I have with him, and I'm so glad that finally I find, because this guy told me he only sells quality stuff. He sells quality stuff and stuff, so things what he thinks are good enough to sell, because there is so much you can buy from China. But the thing is, you all remember I made these, this is my these are the videos I made from China replica. China replica part 1, 2, 3. Musical Sword got Hi-Fi and replica Equiphase E600 vs the real Equiphase. A price difference from, well, 90% or 900% price difference. So 10 times more. You understand? So I made these videos because at a certain moment I want to take the gamble and think, wow, I want this thing, man, only 900, this thing is cost only 900 euro, and also all these things are cheap, far more cheaper than you would pay for a real Equiphase, you understand? And well, I stopped doing this because I think these sellers, I don't know who these sellers are. They sell one piece, you understand? Maybe you will not get your money. Maybe you will get, or maybe you lose your money, you don't get the product. Maybe you get the product, but the product is bad because they use cheap, you know, cheap stuff inside, cheap travel, cheap over here. Or everything is cheap, maybe. I'm not sure, you understand? Because that's the problem. You don't know where to buy, who to trust, huh? If it is really sounding good. If you get the thing in your house and you paid your money, once you paid your money is gone. You cannot ask your money back if you don't like the sound. So you cannot mail the guy and say, well, I want my money back because the sound is not good. No, the guy will not do that, nobody. So you can only spend your money once, my friend. So that's why I always have ideas, but when I start thinking good, I think no, I can lose my 1,000 euro for a bad sounding thing, or a thing what maybe even don't even come to my house. You know, I like to take risk, you know, but not these risks. These are stupid risks. But this guy is 100% trustworthy. If you order, you get the product. And I think what he told me, that everything he is selling is from exceptional quality. So if he sells here for only 200 US dollar this tube amp, or this what, another tube amp, then the quality of this tube amp, both of these tube amps, is good. You understand? We all know that China, that all tubes today, almost all tubes are made in China. Also, if you see those high-end amplifiers from Western companies who have, for example, amplifiers between 20 and 30 and 40,000 euro, they use the same tubes as, well, they use Chinese, made in Chinese tubes. All tubes are made now in China. So if you know that, if you know that all these tubes are made in China, they are cheaper, they are way cheap in China, yes? Then you know that for stereo builders, yes, for hi-fi equipment builders, a lot of European, Japanese, and American high-end companies build their stuff these days in China because they can find cheaper the parts. The parts are cheaper in China. Yes, that's one reason. And labor is cheaper, and that's why, for example, this Meizing. You understand this Meizing tube amplifier, integrated tube amplifier. For the quality you pay, so for the $835 quality in Europe or in America, you have to pay for a European or American same quality, maybe between 5 and 10 times more. That's the difference. So for $835. You buy a product what would cost you new in Europe from a European factory, probably 5 or 10 times more. That's the difference, my friends. That's why I am so in. I want to buy quality for, well, for a reasonable price. Reasonable. You understand what I mean? I don't think I like Accuphase, but I don't think for an integrated amp, 2 times 100 watt. They sell now for 10,000 euro. You understand? I don't think that's fair. I like the brand Accuphase because they make exceptional good amplifiers, beautiful sounding. But why do it have to cost 10,000, 20,000 euro? It's not necessary at all because they build them far cheaper. And these factories, the Chinese factories, have a huge market, 1,200,000,000 people living there. They also sell to Europe, Japan, and America. So they have a huge market, so they can produce mass. They have mass production, those Western companies, they do not produce in mass, you understand? And that's why the more you build from your first series, the cheaper you can produce. And these guys, well, this guy just started their project, and they say, okay, Jacquin MC100B, well, let's make 1,000. You understand? Let's make 2,000. First production line, let's make 3,000 or 5,000. You understand? Where European factories say, well, let's start making 50, let's start making 100. You understand? But they ask more money. So, in the end, if they sell 100 products, it's the same as a Chinese company sells 1,000 for the same profit. A Chinese company have to sell 1,000 to have the same profit as a European or American company who sells only 100 because they sell 10 times more expensive. That's the reason why Chinese stuff is this cheap. Very cheap, my friends. This is unbelievable cheap. And you buy quality. Oh, this is nice, but there's no price. Oh, this is new products for October. So this guy is changing his products all the time. Every month he has new products. And I am not really interested in reviewing earnobs. You understand? I just bought a new headphone here, over here. I'm more a headphone guy. So I don't like these earnobs. I like the sound, but I don't like to push them in. I bought this. Oh, you will see. I will make my next video maybe this from this headphone, my very first Bluetooth headphone. And I already because I don't I now work with this Bluetooth, and I discovered I don't like working with it. So I already promised it to my daughter. She was here and she loved the sound and say, well, after review, you can have it because I paid 80 euro for the thing. And you will hear the story when I make the video. Anyway, I hope the cooperation with this guy will take a long, long time. And watch this. This guy, Audiophile caught for only 50 euro. Unbelievable. Unbelievable these prices, and that once in a while, maybe once a month, maybe once in 2 months, I can have a device and test it for you. So you heard what I actually will think from the thing. And well, this was it. That's what I wanted to tell you. That and this guy, if you see here on the left side, you can see this guy sells a lot of items. But every item, according to him, is the best sound quality. So he doesn't, because the Chinese market is far bigger than what he is selling. You understand? But he only sells the good stuff. He doesn't sell rubbish. You understand? This guy is only selling good stuff. So this is these are the brands he is one the well. I don't think maybe he have more, but these are all the brands he is selling. Most of them are Chinese, and we all know that Chinese have good things like everywhere else and bad things. And this guy is selling the good stuff. So that's first. You know, you understand? If after this video you go, I will place the link from this website in my description box. Also the links from the beamers I'm gonna think of buying, and the Russian guy who do the VS test between these two beamers, and I will do a link from this website, and I can tell you without, you understand, without doing business already with this guy, because I checked this guy out on internet, and I discovered that this guy is very trustworthy. But you can, if you see something nice, you know, cord, headphone, I'm not sure what you see, speakers, you know, it is trustworthy to order to buy this guy. And everything he is selling is from good, very good sound quality. That's what I understand between our email contact, that he is only selling the good stuff. That, you know, he can sell 10 times more, he told me, 100 times more products, but he is only selling the best. And this is this website. So, and I hope I will review, my first review will come out soon enough, you know, because I'm so curious. I'm so curious, my friends. Never had a tube amp, you know. Ivor, my neighbor, my audiophile neighbor, swore with tubes. And probably if my first item arrive, I immediately will go to Ivor, to his house. He have an audiophile living room, and to test it over there, because on both places, you understand. And well, thanks for watching this video. Put your thumbs up if you like it, and for now I say ciao ciao.